having a taste for ghastliness, I had rather longed for the wounded to arrive, for rheumatism wasn't heroic, neither was liver complaint, or measles. Even fever had lost its charms since bathing burning brows had been used up in romances, real and ideal. But when I peeped into the dusky street lined with what I at first had innocently called market carts, now unloading their sad freight at our door, I recalled sundry reminiscences I had heard from nurses of longer standing. My ardor experienced a sudden chill, and I indulged in a most unpatriotic wish that I was safe at home again, with a quiet day before me, and no necessity for being hustled up, as if I were a hen and had only to hop off my roost, give my plumage a peck, and be ready for action. A second bang at the door sent this recreant desire to the right about, and a little woolly head popped in, and Joey, a 6 years old contraband, announced, "Miss Blake's is just wild for ye, and says fly round right away. They's come in, I tell yer, heaps on 'em. One was took out dead, and I seen 'em, ha! Warn't he a goner?" With which cheerful intelligence the imp scuttled away, singing like a blackbird, and I followed, feeling that Richard was not himself again, and wouldn't be for a long time to come. The first thing I met was a regiment of the vilest odors that ever assaulted the human nose, and took it by storm. Cologne, with its 77 evil savors, was a posy bed to it, and the worst of this affliction was, everyone had assured me that it was a chronic weakness of all hospitals, and I must bear it. I did, armed with lavender water, with which I so besprinkled myself and premises that, like my friend Sari, I was soon known among my patients as the nurse with the bottle. Having been run over by three excited surgeons, bumped against by migratory coal-hods, water-pails, and small boys, nearly scalded by an avalanche of newly filled teapots, and hopelessly entangled in a knot of colored sisters coming to wash, I progressed by slow stages upstairs and down till the main hall was reached, and I paused to take breath,